Oh, hello. You wouldn't happen to be one of the Class 7 students from Thor's, would you? Out for a little late night shopping, are we? You're one of the favorite topics at our radio station, actually. There are plenty of people out there who want to know more about Thor's dashing guys and gals in red. Oh, really? By the time morning rolls around, I'm usually so out of it. I hope I didn't look like I was about ready to keel over. Oh, maybe you know me from the radio? Good evening, everyone. This summer's turning into a real scorcher, isn't it? To beat the heat, we're going to be broadcasting tonight from a park here in Trista. Ring any bells? Bingo! You must be quite the avid listener, recognizing my voice so easily. Glad to know I've got a faithful fan out there. Thanks. But it sure is serendipitous, you know? Having a chance encounter like this, just after the rain's eased up. Ooh, maybe I should mention this on tonight's show. Is something the matter? You're staring at me so intently, I feel a little embarrassed. Wow, I can't believe it. I never figured anyone would actually catch on. Right you are once again. Honestly, even the people I work with at the radio station don't seem to have noticed, so I'm surprised you could tell. It's just a little something I do for fun on the side. Gotta spice life up a bit, right? The best part is, the people at the Opera House in Heimdall have no idea I come here to do my show every week. So don't go telling anyone, okay? It'll be our secret. Well, there's a little trick to it. You're not the only one who was surprised, though. I had this feeling I'd seen you before, but I couldn't put my finger on where. But it's you, isn't it? Anyway, I have to get over to the studio now. Oh, and be sure to tune in to tonight's Oven Time. It'll be a fun one, promise. And give my regards to those two, would you? Returned a short while ago. Were you out shopping? Wait,
Do I smell lavender on you? This is perfume, isn't it? How did it get onto you? Reen, I can only hope the reason you ended up taking longer than expected isn't because you were... I never said it was. Though you do seem strangely defensive for a man who has nothing to hide. Huh. I wonder what would happen if Elise and the other girls were to catch wind of this.
Ah, Master Reen. I see you've returned. Were you able to get everything I asked for?
August 18th, and we're winding down a busy day here at 9 p.m. I'm here to give you all the cool you need to beat this summer heat. Seems like those hot summer days keep coming with no end in sight, doesn't it? But even this heat can't stop the momentum behind the West Emuria Trade Conference being held in Crossville later this month. Prince Oliver and Chancellor Osborne will be in attendance for this watershed moment in international business. Are being held in. In some news closer to home, you all have probably noticed the summer showers we're getting here in Trista. The rain's let up for now, but it's managed to push that nasty nighttime humidity right off the charts. It's nights like these I wish I could smuggle an ice-cold beer into the studio. And the director is chilling over there, drink in hand, mocking me. But you know what? Forget that guy. Anyway, for all you students out there, your summer vacation's probably wrapping up, so I hope you made the most of it. Wait, I forgot that summer vacation at the military academy is already come and gone. Whoops. Still, it's never too late to do something bold that'll keep your memories of this summer burning bright. And what about you, Miss Misty? You're probably asking yourselves. Well, you might want to sit down for this one. Because fate had a romantic rendezvous in store for yours truly just on the way to the studio today. A tryst with a young man in a park after sunset. Droplets of rain clinging to the grass. I'll treasure the memory forever. Or I would, if I hadn't just made it up on the spot. Chalk it up to a dreamer's poetic license, I guess. Still, maybe one day I'll feel the thrilling rush of a summer love. Gotta keep the fire burning.
Anyway, I have to get over to the studio now. Oh, and be sure to tune in to tonight's Aubin Time. It'll be a fun one. Promise. And give my regards to those two, would you?
Good to see you, boss.
Oh, you're awfully early.
Well met, Comrade V, Comrade S. I see that you finished all your preparations as well.
Smooth as silk. Although you're the one who'll be taking center stage in our next operation when I'm done.
Who'd have thought you'd volunteer to go pound the pavement and crossbow? The Red Constellation are gonna be there. I still think I'm the prime choice for this one.
I disagree. As I can no longer rely on the power of the fleet, it makes the most sense for me to go. Especially when you consider the very real possibility that we may have to accept a necessary sacrifice for the greater good. That is the best way for us to achieve what we desire.
You're serious?
You really are too morose for your own good.
I could say the same of both of you. Why else would you have willingly plunged yourselves into a struggle like this to begin with?
I suppose you're right.
You got us there.
I see you've all gathered.
Comrade C.
Fashionably late, but worth the wait.
It makes it a full house.
I appreciate your gathering, comrades. The wheels have been set in motion. There is no place for hesitation, no time for looking back. We seek only results.
I couldn't agree more.
No objections here, either.
Goes without saying.
That said, I will ask you but once. Comrade G, are you certain this is the path you would walk?
My heart itself beats with the ideals of the Liberation Front. If my life should see its end in Crossfire, so be it. That tyrant must be stopped from creating the vile dystopia he seeks. Deliver the cost of money. Through our efforts, we or anyone anywhere succeeds in that aim, we will have our victory.
Very well. May the goddess, or perhaps powers less fair, attend you. When this is over and our victory won, let us toast our success together. In the Imperial Capital.
Indeed. Farewell.
He doesn't know how to express any feelings, but I understand.
Losing your place in the world for doing what's right, and throwing yourself into the eye of the storm, it ain't something I can do.
Different paths brought each of us here, but the road we travel now is the same. Let us depart, Comrade S. We each have our own part to play in what is to come.
Of course.
Just leave it to us.
Stay on guard and don't get cocky. Leave it to me.
Very well. Leave it to me.
something from the Academy. You did really well, Reen.
She holds her own in class, to be sure. But at times like these, she seems like any other kid her age.
I'm looking forward to finally getting the chance to visit Laura's hometown.
I've heard that Legram is known for both its many legends and for the mist that hangs over the town for much of the year.
I don't know which stories you've heard, but most of them have been exaggerated in the retelling over time. It certainly doesn't lack for scenic beauty, though. I was hoping I'd have the opportunity to invite you to see it. Though I wish Elisa, Fee, and the others in Group B could have come with us.
Me too. I hope they enjoy their trip.
Sorry to keep you waiting.
Uses.
Good heavens.
Can someone do something about this child? She's out of control.
Thank you.